गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, हेलो एंड वेलकम टू द वीकली कमोडिटी ऑडियोकास्ट। आई एम कायना चैनवाला फ्रॉम कोटक सिक्योरिटीज़ कमोडिटीज़ रिसर्च डेस्क, एंड लाइक इन एवरी एपिसोड टुडे आल्सो विल बी डिस्कसिंग ऑन गोइंग डेवलपमेंट्स इन द कमोडिटी मार्केट्स, फैक्टर्स इन्फ्लुएंसिंग मार्केट ट्रेंड्स एंड अनकवरिंग द लेटेस्ट डेवलपमेंट्स इन दिस डायनामिक वर्ल्ड ऑफ कमोडिटीज़। सो जस्ट लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। इट वुड नॉट बी रियली एन एग्जैजरेशन टू से दैट मार्केट्स हैव बीन एक्सट्रीमली वॉलेटाइल दिस वीक। वॉट वी हैव सीन इज दैट all the asset classes including currencies, equities, commodities all have seen extreme movement, sharp moves in this week. In fact, we saw dollar and US treasury yields hitting the highest levels since November because of strongest indications by the European Central Bank that it will start unwinding its unprecedented hiking campaign soon, coupled with delayed prospects of Fed rate cuts. Now that the Fed rate cuts have been pushed to the second half and ECB indicating that it might start the rate cut soon, markets are expecting probably the first rate hike from ECB in June, and that is why we have seen dollar rallying to 106 levels. Also, US inflation data turned out mixed as CPI rose 0.4% month on month in March compared to 0.3% expectations, beating estimates, while PPI was up 0.2% month on month in March versus 0.3% expectations. Now, hotter CPI figures have actually killed hopes of a June rate cut, pushing Fed pivot wagers to second half of 2024. Along with this, risk sentiments have also been hurt by ongoing geopolitical tensions in the Middle East and Ukraine, which led to sell-off on the Wall Street as well. Now, even if you talk about the FOMC March meeting minutes, it has showed that the Fed does not expect it will be appropriate to reduce the target range until it has gained greater confidence that inflation is moving sustainably towards 2%. Policymakers generally noted the uncertainty about the persistence of high inflation and expressed the view that recent data had not increased their confidence that inflation was moving sustainably down to 2%. So overall, FOMC officials have been reiterating about the patience and not to rush into rate cuts. Similarly, we saw several comments from some Fed officials who have reiterated that trimmed expectations for rate cuts this year, and they would want to want to see the economic data and then decide on the Fed pivot. Interestingly, if we talk about gold prices, for most of the week, gold prices were hitting fresh highs almost in all the sessions of this week, despite stronger greenback and hardening US Treasury yields. Gold has achieved a remarkable feat this year and advanced almost 18% so far, extending gains after 13% upside seen in 2023. One of the main reasons behind this has been robust central bank buying, and recent figures from China has showed that PBOC purchased gold for a 17th straight month in March, extending a buying spree, which is definitely one of the primary reasons for this relentless rally in gold. COMEX gold hit a fresh all-time high of $2,448 per troy ounce, witnessing a fourth weekly consecutive gain fueled by escalation in geopolitical situation. However, after hitting those high levels, gold prices pulled back sharply and they could not retain about $2,400 per ounce, and closed the week with a marginal 0.5% gain compared with a 3% weekly gain earlier. Also, if we see on the daily chart, MCX Gold June has formed a shooting star candlestick pattern indicating indecision in price. In addition, RSI 14 is hovering around 89.93 levels, affirming that the counter is in its overbought zone. If prices sustain below 71,800, then it might test its next support, which is placed at around 70,400. Now, talking about base metal prices, base metals have seen a similar trend. We had seen base metals rally throughout the week, mostly benefiting from supply tightness concerns. LME copper surged to $9,590 per ton for the first time since May 2022, supported by plummeting Chinese treatment charges, which indicates concentrate tightness. While zinc extended an 8% weekly gain for the second week in a row, amid brighter demand prospects for steel as China is entering the construction season, which is from April to May. So overall, it was because of the supply, favorable supply side dynamics that supported the base metal prices. However, similar to gold, the upside in dollar and weak market sentiments hurt base metal prices, which actually came off the recent highs hit during the week. On the other hand, crude oil swung between gains and losses this week as on one side, markets assess the geopolitical tensions, which have escalated as market on escalated following reports of Israel preparing for a revenge assault from Iran in the next 2 days. While on the other hand, we saw bearish in US inventory report and cautious demand outlook from the International Energy Agency. IEA cut 2024 oil demand forecast to 1.2 million barrels per day from previously 1.3 million barrels per day, and said that the pace of expansion is set to further decelerate in 2025. Now, for the major focus would remain on the geopolitical tension, which is expected to worsen as an attack by Iran on Israel is feared as soon as this weekend. Iran's response to Israel's attack could actually jeopardize the fate of the entire region, because this could very well escalate into a regional conflict. So the major focus would be there, and if the conflict escalates, then definitely it's going to be very bullish for oil prices, and to some extent for safe haven assets like gold and dollar, while it will definitely weigh down on global risk sentiment, hurting base metals and equities. So that will be something that will decide the fate of markets next week. Apart from that, on the data front, we have US retail sales and industrial production data coupled with speeches from FOMC members. Since the recent data has kind of trimmed the possibility of a July rate cut to just 43.5%, and the June rate cut bets have already been wiped off, the data that's coming in will be very important for shaping rate cut expectations. Also, inflation remains a major concern, as we have seen that the University of Michigan survey of consumers showed that both year ahead and long run inflation expectations ticked up in April, as year ahead inflation expectations rose to 3.1% from 2.9%, while long run expectations ticked up to 3% from 2.8%. So, overall inflation definitely remains a concern for the US, which actually, pushes back prospects of Fed rate cuts even more. So that will be important. So the data that's coming in from the US will definitely be closely watched. Apart from that, we will also see how Chinese data fares, because disappointing inflation and trade figures have come this week have highlighted demand challenges and renewed concerns of economic recovery. So next week, the string of data releases from China, if they continue to highlight a fragile economic recovery, then definitely one of the things would be that it will be slightly negative for its sentiments. But if triggers calls from the industry to call for a major stimulus response, and if at all we get a indication of stimulus from the Chinese authorities, then definitely this could turn a negative situation to a slightly positive one. So that will be something that will be watched closely. So overall, the focus would be on the most important thing is definitely going to remain the geopolitical conflict between Israel and Iran. That will shape the overall tone for the markets in the next week. On that note, we wrap up this edition of Commodity Audiocast, and we hope we were able to provide you valuable insights. Thank you so much for tuning in today, and we look forward to having you with us next week. Till then, happy trading. Thank you so much.